Our coursework starts from the first year itself, where you will be doing a mix of preparatory courses and sometimes MBA courses. If you do not have enough of a background in management, we will ask you also to do some MBA courses to give you a flavor for what marketing and management are about before you start doing other PhD courses. The PhD coursework in the marketing area can be divided into the following parts. The first part prepares you for the content of the research that has been done in the different areas of marketing, which are consumer behavior, quantitative methods, strategy, and international marketing. So, for example, if you were to be focusing on doing research on consumer behavior, you will be required to do courses such as neuroscience, behavioral theories and marketing applications, experimental methods, and so on. If you were doing quantitative methods, you would need to focus much more on courses like marketing methods, marketing models, econometrics, microeconomics, and so on. Marketing as an area, as I said a little while ago, has four distinct sub-areas, if you will. Consumer behavior, broadly speaking, where one looks at research related to consumers. How do consumers make decisions? Why do they prefer a particular brand versus another? How do they react to prices? And so on. Then there is quantitative methods, where one looks at different quantitative approaches, from the simple stuff like simple linear regression, to more advanced stuff like time series analysis, to be able to analyze the masses of data that are existent out there, whether it's online data, text analysis data, scanner panel data from telecom companies or from retailers, to be able to gain insights on what are some underlying behavioral regularities by customers, which then allow us to make some predictions on what is going to happen if we give a particular offer to a customer. The third broad area is marketing strategy, where we look at the impact of how different marketing decisions lead to changes in positions in the marketplace, how you analyze the competition, how if you change a particular part of your marketing mix, is it likely to change your competitive position in the marketplace. And the last part, of course, is international marketing and international business, as to what are some key questions to ask over there in international marketing. How do you choose a particular country to go into? How do you invest in a market? What is the mode of entry into a particular market? As a faculty, we have researchers who are doing work in all of these areas: consumer behavior, in quantitative methods, in strategy, and in international marketing. And I would encourage you to explore your own inclinations as you apply for a PhD in the marketing area at IIM Ahmedabad. Do we have a strong preference for any particular type of person who wants to come into the program? In general, it helps if you have some work experience, but it's not a requirement. In the last entering batch, we had one person who was almost fresh out of undergraduate college, and we did go ahead and hire him as a PhD student. We've also had people who have been in their early 40s and mid 40s who have joined the PhD program because in our assessment, that person really wanted to do a PhD program. So to summarize the following 5 points for the marketing PhD program that I would like to keep you, keep in mind. The first is that the purpose is to create new marketing professors, consultants, who have the ability to conceptualize and research problems at a very high level of fidelity, where one can say something with a 99% accuracy rather than a 70% accuracy. The second point was about the structure of the course. It varies from 4 to 6 years. The first 2 years is on coursework, and the remaining 2 to 4 years is on doing your own independent research under a PhD student guide. Having said that, we expect you to do research right from the beginning, rather than just wait for it and start in the third year. There is a comprehensive exam at the end of 2 years that you have to clear to proceed further in the program. The key point to note, which is the third point, is that doing research is about creating new knowledge. And so you should be doing a generalized problem, not a company-specific problem. That is the nature of true academic research that adds to the knowledge that's existing, which can then feed itself back into the classroom over a period of time. The fourth point was choosing a guide that will guide you through the PhD process, especially after your comprehensive exam. We do have an academic advisor who helps you to fine-tune to hone in on your research problem in the first 2 years, but that guide is may or may not be your final thesis guide. That final thesis guide has to be chosen on the basis of expertise in the particular area that you are interested in pursuing your PhD thesis, and also the level of comfort that you have in working with him, partly because it's almost an apprenticeship model. It's a craft that you're learning while doing a PhD. And of course, once you graduate, there are good job opportunities in academia, in consulting. So thank you once again for listening to me, and I do hope that you decide to apply to the marketing PhD program at IIM Ahmedabad.
Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Naman Desai. I am an associate professor with the finance and accounting area at the Indian Institute of Management Ahmedabad, and I'm here to talk about the PhD program that we offer in the areas of finance and accounting. While our area is referred to as the finance and accounting area, the PhD program is offered, the PhD program offers two distinct tracks, a finance track and an accounting track, and the necessary and applicable coursework has been designed to give the incoming PhD students the necessary expertise in their particular track. The finance track typically deals with research in the topics of behavioral finance, empirical asset pricing, banking, international finance, derivatives and equity markets, and so on. The accounting track typically deals in research related to corporate governance, earnings management, and auditing.
Hi everyone, this is Promila Agarwal, faculty from Human Resource Management Area, IIMA. I joined this institute in the year 2013. So what is unique about PhD from our area is the sheer diversity of projects that we lead. Our projects are not just limited to testing a research idea or research model. It extends to leading live projects, projects for government, projects for private sector, projects for public sector, health sector, and government agencies not only in India but also outside the India. Some of the research areas that we are currently working upon are philosophical of HRM foundations, international HRM, psychology of leadership, neuroscience of decision making, then employee relations, then managing hospital management systems, hospital management, business turnaround. These are just to name a few. The second most unique thing about our area is a strong connect that we have with industry and government. And because of this connect, the research output is significantly relevant and directly relevant in terms of business and social impact. The third most unique thing is that we are actively involved in framing strategies for the organization, designing processes, systems and structures for them. Now, what this all means for PhD applicants is that there is an ecosystem in the area where applicants from different walks of life can pursue their different career aspirations and their career goals. Here, and also the ones who are a little confused about the kind of research that they want to pursue. Here you can shadow all the professors and explore for yourself the kind of work that you want to do, the kind of work that excites you. We actively work with our FPM fellows as partners. They actively collaborate with us on different kind of projects. So our area in short is perfect for applicants who are very passionate about research and consulting and advisory and making change to the society, having a business both through making business impact as well as social impact.